And the ASEAN+3 Macroeconomic Research Office says regional growth might be shaved off because of the virus outbreak. AMRO joins other institutions flagging the latest event risk roiling regional growth prospects. With us now for more, live from Singapore, is Dr. Hoe Ee Khor, the Chief Economist of the ASEAN+3 Macroeconomic Research Office, or AMRO. Good to have you back on, Dr. Khor. Welcome to the program.
Morning, Kathy. Great to be in.
All right. So the key concern here is what happens to China's economy following the virus outbreak. Could you give us the likely scenarios?
Well, we are monitoring the situation very closely. As you know, we just recently upgraded the growth rate by about 0.2 percentage point because of the truce in the trade war, right? So we had just recently done that. And then we had this coronavirus outbreak. And we are now reviewing it because initially, I think the assessment was that the virus doesn't pass from person to person, but then it started spreading very rapidly. So now they have a lockdown on Wuhan, and you know there's a freeze on outflow of tourists out of China. So this is a very major step taken by the Chinese government to stop the spread of the virus, and it's likely to have an impact on the economy. So we are in the process of reviewing the impact on the economy. I think so far, you know, the estimate has been between 0.1 to 0.3 percentage point of GDP for the whole year. We expect the virus to the epidemic to spread until about within 3 to 6 months, and then to turn around. So there are a range of estimates, and we still to see how the thing spread. But the data from today, the report today, that the death rate has gone down to 25. The day before it was 50, right? So there is some indication that perhaps the virus has been contained, and that it's going to slowly become less and less. So this is a good sign.
Okay, allow me to crunch the numbers. I know that you're still working on it, but prior to the virus outbreak, your office revised upwards to 4.9% from 4.7% the ASEAN+3 GDP prospects for 2020. So which among the drivers of this upward revision now stand in peril if the virus outbreak remains uncontained?
That's correct, yes. So this is why it's very important to contain the virus as quickly as possible. Of course, there'll be a short run cost because when you impose the lockdown, everything comes to a halt, and it's going to affect wholesale and retail business, hospitality, and you know, especially the services industry will be very badly affected. But you know, we know from experience from the previous experience SARS that it is going to be short term, and the question is whether you know we get over it within 3 or 6 months. But our assessment is that, you know, the shave off from the growth rate will be between 0.1 to 0.3 percentage point.
Okay, so what is short term? Could you define for us, are you building scenarios, maybe 1 to 3 months, 2 to 3, based on the experience from SARS in 2003?
That's correct. I think the expectation is that by April, I think they'll be turning around, and then maybe by June, they'll declare that the epidemic is over. So we are talking between 1 to 2 quarters of growth that will be affected by this SARS. And then in the second half, there will be a rebound, obviously. And so for the whole year, growth rate will be shaved down by about 0.1 to 0.3 percentage point.
On a broader scale, Dr. Khor, what might a slower growing China mean for the ASEAN, now more exposed to China following the global supply chain realignments that ensued as firms sought alternative sources of goods and foreign direct investments in ASEAN economies in response to the U.S.-China trade war?
Yes, I think the impact on the ASEAN economy will depend on how open they are to China in terms of the tourism trade. And we know that in the region, many countries have become increasingly dependent on Chinese tourism. It varies from, you know, like in the case of Thailand, about 25% of the tourists to Thailand are from mainland China, from China, and to Cambodia, where it's about 30%. So depending on this, on the dependence on the tourism, you know, that's going to be affected. And the impact could be, again, between about 0.1 percentage point to 0.2, 0.3 percentage point, depending on how big the tourism sector is for the economy.
What about the Philippines? How is it looking in your assessment? It is equally exposed, but not quite so. You've got a lot of Chinese tourists and Chinese businesses here in the online gaming sector.
Yes, I think in the case of the Philippines, the size of the Chinese tourists to the economy is not as big, but it's big for certain sectors of the economy. As you said, the online gaming industry is quite large. So that industry may be affected to some extent because it would imply that there'll be. I think the Philippines already announced that they're not going to allow tourists from Wuhan and Hubei province to come to Philippines. So tourism will be affected in the online gaming industry. But overall, I think that the tourism industry in the Philippines is less dependent on Chinese tourists than the other countries in the region.
Yeah, but even they have been affected, like the Koreans. And when you talk tourism, you talk the multiplier effect. There's been this robust consumption, local consumption, that's really underpinning growth here in the Philippines. So what sort of a negative knock-on would that have on consumption if the tourist numbers were to fall temporarily because of the virus?
It will shave off growth slightly, but I think that the bigger issue for the Philippines is the bounce back from the budget delay in the first half of last year. And so far, the recovery has been going on quite smoothly, and we expect that to continue this year. So that's why we kept the growth forecast for this year at 6.4%, which is actually very strong for the whole region. With this outbreak of the virus, the growth could be shaved off by 0.1 percentage point, possibly. We are still monitoring how this is going to work out. And it obviously depends also on what happened in China itself. If the impact on China is big, then it'll have a bigger impact on the Philippines. By the moment, our best estimate is that it could shave growth off perhaps by 0.1 to 0.2 percentage point for the Philippines.
And that would put the Philippines still at the top of the stack in the ASEAN?
Yes. I mean, at the moment, I think Philippines has probably the highest growth among the emerging markets in ASEAN. Is 6.4 is higher than most of the other emerging markets in ASEAN. So, and you say that way because it's mostly driven by domestic spending. And so we expect the budget this year to be on track at 3.2% of GDP. And so, I think it's going to be supported by investment and consumption much more than the external side. On the external side too, the semiconductor industry is turning around, and that will also give a boost to the semiconductor industry, electronic industry in the Philippines.
All right, there's a silver lining. And I know you're very busy crunching the numbers. Keep us up to speed when you get down to the revisions. Thank you so much for joining us. Dr. Hoe Ee Khor of ASEAN+3 Macroeconomic Office, live in Singapore.